Hi, I'm Natasha, and in this video, I'll show you how I made this sound-reactive LED mask for my Lady Gaga cosplay.
One, two, make it stupid! I want you stupid!
In this build, I uncovered the actual materials used in Lady Gaga's LED mask from the VMAs, and tweaked the design to be a simpler version that's more appropriate for cosplay. I also made Gaga's bodysuit, wig and accessories, and a companion costume, her brain piano. I'll be making a video about how I made each, so be sure to subscribe for more. I started off this project wondering how I was going to make this animation in the front of the mask, and I was lucky enough to find the company that had actually made the original. They were called Smooth Technology, and they actually posted on Instagram images of them making this mask, and most importantly, an image of the back so I could see the type of display, the type of microphone. This was a gold mine for my project. So to make sense of what I found, I sketched the circuit with colored pencils in my sketchbook and got started on building the display. I'll put links in the description to all of the products that I found so that you can use them too. The matrix was a matrix of matrices, of these Adafruit DotStar LED grids. The mounting holes needed to be cut off to make them fit together, and I sanded the edges to make them sit nice and flush. I added some electric tape to hold them in place and started soldering the wires according to my diagram. There were so many wires to solder, so to keep them straight, I connected all the power, then ground, then data, then clock pins together. And when I was done, I had a matrix of matrices. To run the display, I connected it to an Itsy Bitsy M4 microcontroller from Adafruit and followed their tutorial on setting up the DotStar matrices, which got me set up fairly quickly, just as soon as I figured out the matrix orientation, which the tutorial helps with. To code the animation, I started with what I was familiar with, a program called Processing. I found a sine wave example on processing.org by Daniel Schiffman, who, by the way, has an amazing YouTube channel that explains how to code basically anything. So I tweaked the example code to look like Gaga's sine wave, then translated the concepts into Arduino so that I could use the Adafruit GFX library to show the wave on the LED display. I'll link to my blog post where I'll post all the code I used and references for you to check out. Now that I had the animation, I wanted it to react to my voice. So the original post said that Lady Gaga controlled the animations with her loudness and pitch, but the lighting designer had wireless control over the color of the animation. But for my version, I didn't need any external control, so I only needed to sample the volume of audio coming from my voice under the mask. I covered the back in electric tape to prevent a short and connected the microphone and microcontroller behind the display. Then I started to experiment with changing the sine wave variables based on the volume input from the mic and tried a few color combinations to see what looked best. I want to be loved, to be loved, to be loved, love, love, to be loved, love, love. And I liked the all pink one the best. Next, I needed to make the project enclosure, or the box that goes around the display. Now, the original mask was 3D printed, but I decided to use just some thin cardboard to create the same box shape. Also, I don't have a 3D printer. I just cut the strips of cardboard into the exact lengths that they needed to be and used super glue to glue them together at 90 degree angles. And I connected the display to the box with some black duct tape. With that all connected, it was time to make the circular frame for the front. I was in luck because I needed a 3-inch circle for this project, and the center of any old tape is a 3-inch circle, so it made the perfect template for this piece. I made sure to be very accurate because this is going to be front and center in the project. And with my circle cut, I was ready to add some vinyl to make it look like a piece of plastic. You can see in this shot that the center circle is shinier than the rest of the mask, so I wanted to use two different types of vinyl to mimic this. I used a matte black vinyl to cover the box, and then I cut the circular shape out of the front of it. This didn't need to be perfect since the other circle would be placed on top. Then I used a shiny black vinyl to cover the ring. This was a little tricky as I had to cut like 1,000 little cuts in to get the vinyl to wrap over the circular edge, but it did work and it came out really nice, I think, in the end. I glued the ring to the main box, and now it was time to add the side pieces. I cut 2 trapezoid-ish shapes from some cosplay foam and taped them to either side of the box. The other thing that I added off camera was this button that is connected to the reset pin. In my code, I have a calibration function at the beginning that sets the minimum and maximum size of the wave based on the ambient volume. So I needed a way to reset it, and I placed that button there so that I could click it with my finger and not have to take the mask off. Next, I added another piece of cosplay foam that would act as the main piece that sits against my face, and I added some ear loops with my sewing machine. I taped the 2 pieces together first to position them correctly, and then I sewed them together as well. I also allowed my power cable that was connected to the microcontroller to escape through one side of this mask. That wire is going to go down to my waist where I'll have a battery pack so that I can power the mask without having the weight of a battery on my face. I also used this ear saver to connect the elastics behind my ears and keep the mask upright. Then I plugged in a USB battery pack and gave it a test. And to finish the build, I used a few pieces of spandex and cut them to size so that they could cover the sides. I just used some hot glue to adhere them. I do wish that I used a different type of glue because it was really difficult to get hot glue to lie flat. Because there's this white box on top of Gaga's mask, I added a little square of white vinyl to match. And to keep my battery in a safe space, I put a little spot in the belt of my costume. And with that, I was ready to rock.
Calibrating, calibrating, la 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 la. I want you to be alive. Should subscribe.